The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines placed the Luzon grid under yellow alert over the weekend following what it called a grid disturbance that led to power interruptions in several areas. Joining us now is Director Mario Marasigan of the Energy Department's Electric Power Industry Management Bureau. Good morning, Director Marasigan. Thanks for taking our call.
Yes, good morning, all.
All right, sir. First off, po, any updates on our power supply grid? We know na NGCP raised a red and then yellow alert in Luzon on Saturday due to insufficient power supply.
Yeah, thank you very much for the question. Actually, during the weekend, we had red and yellow alerts, not because of supply interruption. There are two major lines connecting the Bataan power facility with more than 800 megawatts online. Two of these major transmission line tripped at around 3 o'clock in the morning, 2:30 in the afternoon on Saturday. And this caused the isolation of all the Bataan power facilities. So since much of these power facilities were totally shut down, it took some difficulties for them to restart their ND online, but the transmission facilities were immediately restored. At the moment, there are also yellow alert situation, which might happen starting at 1 o'clock in the afternoon until 3 o'clock this afternoon. But these are brought about by the continuous inavailability of some of our Bataan power facilities, and at the same time, we had some concerns with our South Luzon power facility.
All right, and Sir Meralco also reported an automatic load dropping or ALD on Saturday, right? What does this actually mean for electricity services to Metro Manila and the adjacent provinces?
Yes, there were automatic load dropping within the franchise area of Meralco last weekend, primarily brought about by my initial explanation on the faults in the two major transmission lines, making unavailable our power facilities from the Bataan area. However, these were immediately addressed, as I mentioned earlier. From red alert, we were able to come into yellow alert towards 3 o'clock or 3:30 on Saturday, but the yellow alert continued until 11 p.m. On Saturday. But everything went fine yesterday until there was also a red alert declaration this afternoon.
Sir, what's causing Puba this drop in power supply now? And why are some areas more affected as compared to others? For like, for example, si Bataan po,
okay. Let me clarify things. No, first, there are sufficient supply in the Luzon grid. Unfortunately, two of our transmission facilities being operated by our system operator, the National Grid Corporation, have some faults that happened Saturday afternoon. This caused the isolation of all the generation facilities in the Bataan area. And this is in the tune of more than 1,000 megawatts. When that situation happened, there were about 800 megawatts that are running and in full operation last Saturday afternoon. So the major cause of the interruption are the transmission lines and not the supply.
Not the supply, so, right?
So since much of the generation facilities have to fully shut down, then it takes some time for them to be online at full capacity. In fact, the GN Power Mariveles, with a total capacity of more than 600 megawatts, are still on their startup phase. And we are yet determining what particular time they will be made available this afternoon.
So, sir, it's not the supply now we're looking at more some problems. It's the transmission lines. But that being said, how are our power plants and transmission lines from the Luzon grid doing now? Do you think we'll be seeing more power interruptions in the days to come?
No, we don't see any power interruption at the moment. As I had mentioned also earlier, the two major lines that were affected last weekend were immediately restored. So upon restoration, it now becomes the start of the generation facilities that take some time. And these are coupled by the continuous outage of some of our generation facilities in South Luzon. So we are hoping that towards the later part of the afternoon, this afternoon, everything will be fine.
Mm-hmm. All right. And one of President-elect Marcos Jr.'s campaign promises was making electricity affordable for all. But what's your take on the idea of looking into nuclear power again as an alternative source of energy?
Well, the Department of Energy is taking the lead in terms of looking into the nuclear generation facilities as an option for us to provide cheaper and cleaner electricity in the future. Of course, we are still building up or rebuilding our capacity in terms of establishing and operating our own nuclear power facilities. We have 19 infrastructure requirements that needs to be done, and at the moment, the Department of Energy, together with all the other government agencies that are members of our interagency nuclear task force, are working on these 19 infrastructure requirements. And hopefully, within the next 10 years, then we will have our first nuclear facility.
Mm-hmm. Right, so this is good news, Paulo. But sir, we've been hearing various names floated for the next DOE chief, but the president-elect himself has yet to name one. But what are you looking for in the next DOE chief?
We have yet to hear from the Office of the President who will be our incoming secretary. And of course, the Department of Energy is always looking forward to the new policy directions of the government.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you for talking to us this morning, Sir Garya. You stay safe.
Thank you very much also, and more power to you.